Hello, comic fans. Here's our Gray. Cheers. I've talked already about the Latvian publisher of mini comics, Kuž, in Panelogy 237. But now I want to talk about their publications from the last wicked year, 2020. And this is only stuff that they put out in the last year, 15 books all in all. You can get them as a package. For 88 bucks. So that's not too bad, I would say. They got me worried a bit because it's clear that they suffered quite a bit in this COVID year here. And the last two offerings in terms of anthologies were called The End and now the most recent one, The Very End. And most of all, there's a comic that reads a bit like an obituary of sorts here. And you already can see the mix of different techniques and ways to do your comic. And here one, Nico Trotti, talks about his one-way relationship, and it becomes clear that he means the publications of Kuž. It's like I got to meet a lot of great human beings just by knowing you. People who, thanks to your help, got to be there for me at random times too. Always near me if I needed a story to turn to. So, and stories to turn to, there are a lot inside of these. Some very simplistic, but nevertheless pretty funny. And some of them, little practices in storytelling. Some more creating an atmosphere like many short comics usually do in other anthologies, not only by Kuž as well. Some formal experiments like you can see here. And what I really like is first, of course, the format, because it's really nice and unpretentious in a way, and that these anthologies are all have a common theme going throughout all these. And here it's worryingly so, The End. And we had another compilation anthology of sorts called The Imperfect Shape or Imperfect Shapes in 2020. And some really played around with these imperfect shapes trope to create unusual stories. Some more realistic, some more abstract. So, I really love these anthologies, but now I want to show you the 12 mini comics, as in booklets, that I got via my subscription in the last year. So we have The Book Fight by one Chi Hoy, and you always find a little summary on the back of it here. But it's about a comic book fighting it out with all other kinds of books on a book fair or book conference, it's called. And he's a bit of the aggressive guy, the comic book, but soon it will turn out that he's not the villain here, actually. This year is actually one of my favorites of the last year, despite it, or maybe because it's very crude and fast-paced and tells a real story. Pirate and Parrot from Lukas Weidinger, about a pirate and his parrot, and doing this kind of business in the harbor. And it's really, really funny, a very loose cartooning, but a real fun story, a bit fairy tale-esque. Liked it a lot. Another favorite here, Harukishi with Hero, and it's all about this DJ cat here. And since we have now a cat for ourselves for a half a year, I really appreciate these cat comics even more. She's really a superhero cat and very brave and has always the brightest ideas, with one exception, which you will witness at the end. Because cats don't like water, you know. And this one here is really great as well. Nicholas Mahler's very special take on James Joyce's Finnegan's Wake. Nicholas Mahler is pretty popular over here. I think he's an Austrian, doing this kind of cartoony, very simplistic, pretty sophisticated at the same time using Irish and English and German slang to mix it up to some kind of proto-language to give us some central scenes, I suppose, from Finnegan's Wake. Talking about familiar comic creators, Mark Bell with Banal Complications, this one here is actually rather an illustrated story or diary of some events that took place while Mark Bell has to deal with art galleries in New York. Rather that than a real comic. You get some reproductions from other artworks in the back. It's every time nice to get something from Mark Bell. But to be honest with you, most of the artists that I got from Kusch were totally unfamiliar to me. But that's great. So it's great to come to know one artist like Tommy Parrish and his story Sufficient Lucidity about a couple, the breaking up of a couple and the bad fallouts between them and how they sort of coming to terms in the end of the story. It's told in an almost conservative style here, as you can see, but nevertheless pretty beautiful, as everything of Kusch in one way or another is beautiful. I guess that's the common thing here. Sometimes you don't get a story, or there is not even a story, like in this book here, Man-Made Lake by Aidan Koch. It's pretty esoteric about the relationship, as far as I get it, of humans and nature, or your own individuality and your inheritance from the nature. I mean, we're all animals when you are evolved from animals, so we have some heritage in us. This is explored in this very atmospheric, very sketchy comic here, using all kinds of things, collages and stuff. Martin's Zutis, Crime at Babel, reminded me, because of the watercolor art style, a bit of Breck Evans. Something has happened here, as you will see. A book has been stolen over there, and lots of other things happened, and you can figure it out if you take your time with this book here. At least I guess. If I'm honest with you, I haven't really figured out what has happened here. This book is from La Bibliotheca de Babel, in case you don't know. Some of the books from Kusch have really, in the most positive sense, a children book quality to them, like this book here from Rupert Rurens, Extraordinary, in which a girl imagines all kinds of fantastic things in pretty familiar objects here. So a carrot becomes a fire breather, or a matchbox with some matches becomes in her mind a clown's car with some clowns, and so on. Just a nice idea, nice art, and sometimes it doesn't have be much more, I guess. Yeah, and here's our girl under some kind of sheet where she imagines all the stuff here. Violent Delights by Juan Hetamoe is a very experimental take on Romeo and Juliet and exploring all kinds of stuff. Maybe a bit too much to pack into one comic book, especially in the size alone. But yeah, maybe you can make more out of this take here. Wasn't my favorite of them all, but not bad either. Johanna Estrella takes a Lithuanian folktale of Egle and the Snake about this girl here who takes a swim in the sea and meets a snake there to tell us this fairy tale on the one side, and on the other side makes pretty clear how timeless the story here actually is. Very nice, and maybe one of the most beautiful books here from Karen Katz. You know her art and stories from different anthologies from Now and whatnot. They are a bit similar to each other, and so you can say if you have seen one of her stories, you have seen them all, but you have to dig a bit more into her stories, I guess, to figure out the very special atmospheric quality of these stories here. Even though it's clear that this is one kind of comic where the art is what pulls you in, and then it makes you think about the story. This is a story about the relationships in a house where they give gifts to each other as a kind of a game. I think it's called Secret Santa. And it got pretty ambiguous in the end. And this is very typical for Karen Katz's stories. And in a way, for a lot of these push books here. So, thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.